In this episode of The Be Bold Show, running a water bottling company, how is it like? Ifor Rida takes us to Nsawam to meet the CEO of Echo Spa Water Limited. These and many more. Coming up now.
Welcome to the Be Bold Show, another exciting episode in store for you. We are so excited to bring you all the guests for today.
Yes, we are. And for our first guest, do you know what a photojournalist does? If you don't, you definitely need to stick around as we look at the winner of the Photojournalist Award in the GJAs in 2011, Jeffrey Buta.
I'm Jeffrey Buta. A family of four and the first male who I want to be inspirational to my younger brothers. And the field of photojournalism was so unique to me. When I started as a photographer before doing the journalism aspect, I didn't need to be on the field. So basically, that's what I want to be, a professional photographer as well.
Are a photo journalist. To be honest, before today, I had no idea that this job existed. I knew that you have journalists and I knew that you had photographers. So how did you mix the two together?
Actually, photo journalism is like telling a story with a photograph. The story goes with photographs. And a photographer is someone who normally go with a reporter to shoot and a reporter writes as well. But basically, photojournalist is recording events for historical use in the future, and it has to be ethnic, not just any photograph or any story you need to write. Yeah. So basically, photojournalism is the combination of the story and the photograph as well.
What do you have to do to be a photojournalist?
It depends. It's what moves you. For instance, for me, I was blessed to discover my destiny as a photojournalist back then, my senior high school. Yes. After that, I tried to build upon it because I've already discovered what I really wanted to do.
But how did you discover your destiny?
I actually discovered my destiny through a friend. Though my father was a police photographer, but he never taught me photography. He never taught me photography.
But he never taught you photography, and then you found it on your own.
Yes.
So it was already obviously in your blood.
Of course. The blood was just moving around, but
exactly.
Never discovered it.
So where did journalism come in?
It was after my school, 3 years program in photography, and I ended up working with Ghanaian Times, which I started doing the journalism aspect there. And through that, they teach you what to do on the field as a journalist. So through those experience that I had, I just started doing something on, I can shoot and write without a reporter there. So basically that's what happened on the floor.
So you became multifunctional?
Yes.
How would you describe your photojournalism?
It's supposed to be assignment-based, particularly social and political significance.
Okay.
But basically for my routine job, you need to be assigned by your editors. Or if you have an interesting story somewhere, you call your editor, please, I have a story here, I want to go and cover. And they'll give you the guidelines and you move out there and do your story. As a media person, a journalist, we are the voice for the voiceless, hope for the hopeless. So we try to bring out some issues that people don't really have access to. You know, with a camera or a media person, you can go into situations where not everyone will get out. The president can go to some villages to see what is happening there. So with your camera, you go there, you come out with a story, and people like, wow, this is happening. Then they move out there to help the people. So as an advocate to help people bring out their issues, this is what I try to do on the phone. future, to be an advocate to change lives.
Now, you also are very focused on road safety advocacy.
Mm-hmm.
What is your cause or your reason for that?
Actually, my reason for advocacy for road safety was when I was transferred to Tamale, the capital of Northern Region. When I got there, I saw a lot of sprinting there compared to that of Accra. I saw people sitting on the tracks, which it seems normal, they are not scared. 8 people on a motorbike, which is not normal. I only see such things in BBC, like India.
So, I was surprised.
That particular day, I got to Tamale when I was transferred. I got there very late, so the following morning, around 5, I took my camera. I just walked down the street, trying to see what is happening there from the morning. And the first shot I got was 8 people on a motorbike. That won me the Best Photojournalist Award.
Wow.
Yeah. So I try to use that one to take what is happening there so that the people can have the negative impact of using those kind of transportation.
Now, you were just saying that you've actually won the Ghana Journalism Award. You have 2 awards here today with you.
Yes.
How did you win them and how did that make you feel?
After winning the Best Photojournalist Award, it was quite a challenge because people are expecting more from you. You don't need to relax. So you need to put more effort. So I decided to put in more effort by winning the Road Safety Award too.
Okay, and this was for your road safety work that we were just talking about.
Yes. As the best print journalist for road safety. So it's quite a challenge. As you are winning this award, you don't have to relax. People are expecting a whole lot from you. So you need to step out there, do more. For people to know that the award that I've given you is worth it.
You've also been featured on CNN iReport and on the European Journalism Center. Can you just share your experience with us? How was it to see your work on an international platform?
I was actually amazed. When you Google in Geoffrey Buta, the first 5 or 10 things that pop out about you will be CNN iReport. Some of the photographs that have been used there, and European Journalism Center, some of the works that have been used there. And I'm so always amazed because I'm local, but I'm branded internationally. So I'm always happy to work more because it's not a really not ordinary work that can go out there.
Okay. Looking into your future, what are you seeing?
I think there's a bigger chance for me out there. Very, very big, huge one that I need to just determine focus and try to let that fire continue to burn each and every day to do a whole lot of creative photojournalism.
For all the young people watching you today who would want to be a photojournalist, why would anyone be a photojournalist and what is the advice that you can give them?
All right, be bolders. I think you have to choose what you love doing and you never get tired working every day. When you choose love doing, you just do it for fun because you have your eyes, your heart, your mind open to that chance and you are not only settled to the surface stuff that you have. You want really to delve into it. So you have to be passionate about what you do. Be determined, get focused and do it. Don't look up for money or for fame. You just do it for fun. As young people getting up there, when you're able to discover your destiny as a photojournalist or anywhere that you want to do, you just have to build upon it. Each day is a gradual process. You have to build upon it each and every day. And definitely you're going to get there one day.
Well, thank you so much. Thank you so much for your words of inspiration. And we will be watching you. And we wish you the best.
Thank you so much.
Geoffrey Buta really has a talent for what he's doing.
Yeah, I'm really surprised at his focus. Like, what exactly he focuses on with regards to traffic safety and all that.
Yeah, that's a very important point for him because he said, especially in the north where he operates a lot, he has an issue with road safety. People are just sitting on the trucks, transporting stuff around, and it's very dangerous, and people don't really...
And he captures this in photography.
Yeah.
Pictures do say 1,000 words.
A thousand words.
Yeah.